It's that time. The phone is ringing every other minute, and you can't find an inch of the floor for all the boxes in the way. And every nook and cranny in the small office has Dick Goddard's face looking right back at you. The time is, well, Woolly Bear time.
Why would you come to Woolly Bear Festival? Woolly Bear is a day, honestly, to be a kid again.
Oh, you can definitely be a kid again. The costumes, the bands, the Woolly Bear races, and just a lot of great things. The whole town is there, along with thousands and thousands, and did I say thousands of folks who all just want to have a good time? And one thing you will always will remember are the sweet treats. When it's Woolly Bear time, no one likes to see a naked apple. But after a caramel bath and chopped nuts to top it all off, it just becomes so good. This is the second batch of about 400 apples that the folks at Brummer's Chocolates have hand-dipped. They've got several thousand more to make if they're going to keep up with a very hungry crowd.
We do put a lot of caramel on, but as you go down to the end of the batch, it gets really thick. So the end of the batch ones are always extra coated.
The folks over at Brummer's have been woolly bearing for years now. And their apples are a tradition for many, many folks. But traditions have to start someplace. So after your apple, how about a Woolly Bear mix? Popping Around Gourmet Popcorn opened their doors on Woolly Bear Sunday just last year. And although they've got dozens of flavors, it's their Woolly Bear mix of orange and chocolate that will start a new tradition for many.
It's great. This town's great. They do so much, you know, to bring people in. And Woolly Bear is just so much fun, you know.
In Vermilion, Roosevelt.